Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and finally I bring to you the Wales campaign on my channel. Many of you guys have been requesting this for a long, long time, and I've promised this campaign for nearly 2 years now. It's been a while. It was one of the things I initially intended to do once I had started a YouTube channel, and it's taken me a long time to get around to it. I waited until a lot of the Rome 2 stuff died down, and I waited for the whole Medieval 2 patches to be finished, because recently, the last sort of few months, there have been minor updates to Medieval 2, and I wanted to kind of get all of that out of the way and start the new year afresh with a brand new campaign. We're playing as Wales. We are playing on very hard difficulty for the difficulty and for the battle difficulty as well. Advice is turned off, as you would expect. We've got show computer moves. We haven't actually got manage all cities. We actually want that, don't we? So we'll have that ticked. No battle time limit, but we will have a time limit in case, of course, something bugs out. Then we got an opportunity to fast forward it and, you know, get back to the campaign map. We have got, let's see what we got. We'll have short campaign on, so whole 25 regions, including Carnarvon, Dublin, London, and eliminate England, of course. We start off with three settlements, and the aim in this campaign is to basically take over England. Defeat England and take all of the English settlements. That would be my aim in this campaign. As always, your feedback would be appreciated. It would help me a lot if you could support this series by leaving a like and dropping a comment. And I think we can start the campaign. So without further ado, I am going to click the start button. Enjoy, guys.
Britannia, a land of emerald isles, a land of kings, a land of war. England. King Henry sits upon a hungry throne, thirsty for more land. The Norwegians, warriors happy to pay the blood price for their ambitions. Scotland, from the highlands and across the lowlands comes a spirited people ready for battle. Wales, a people of song and sword, and leaders that will bend their knees to no man. And Ireland, suspicious of his neighbors, the Irish warrior never sleeps, though he dreams of conquest. Britannia, one realm, five kings, total war.
So there we have it. That's the introduction video for this campaign, Britannia campaign. It's been a long, long time since I played Medieval 2. This will most probably be the only time that you will see me play Medieval 2 on my YouTube channel. I have played as Wales in this campaign previously. That was on hard difficulty, and it was probably about 6 years ago now, so it's a long, long time since I played this campaign. So let's have a quick look at what we have. We have a ship here, Admiral Ship's Howell. Ready. And what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to take this ship over to... I'm going to take it to my Side port, side. Actually. Get the ship in the port, Welsh docks.
Fine day to sail.
Pembroke. We have Merionoedd Spearman, Scythier Bowman, and Merionoedd Spearman again. Made thee, my general. And recruit some units from here, of course, as well. Cardiff is going to be the first aim in this campaign. In modern day Wales, Cardiff is the capital of our city, but in this campaign it starts off under English territory. Our aim will be to stop that and take it straight away. If we double click on Cardiff, it actually shows that 90% of the population are Welsh anyway, and it will give us some decent growth and some decent money as well. So we want to take Cardiff straight away and get the English on the back foot. So it's basically take Cardiff and then push out to Gloucester, Shrewsbury and Chester and take the border settlements, the marsh settlements. My merchant is useless here. Let's take him over to the English border. He can do some scouting for me. On my way. Some unofficial scouting. Same with my spy, he can go north to Lancaster. Check out what is in Lancaster. I have two spies, one to go north, one to go south, I think. Keep him there for now. He's quite useful near Shrewsbury. I need to take advantage of these free upkeep units as well. Units in this game, some of them do tend to be free, so I want to try and make use of that if and when possible. Rodri, but there, he could probably be used to take back Cardiff. My Welsh diplomat is going to go north to Scotland straight away.
Without question,
reason for this is Scotland most likely going to end up against England later in the campaign, so it's probably a good idea to do that. And Cardiff has 6 units in total, so what we need to do is be in a good position to take Cardiff. So what we're going to do is take Merthyr and his units out, put them in the fort.
With honor, sire.
These 6 units are going to be used to attack Cardiff. We're going to march straight towards them. Pembroke is fine left undefended. No need to be defensive in this campaign, especially early on. We're going to leave Pembroke like that and go straight for Cardiff.
By your will, sire,
with my 6 units. Now, of course, we need to be wary of an English counterattack. So, Montgomery, it would be wise to take all of my units from Montgomery and actually attack Shrewsbury in the first turn with all of my might in Montgomeryshire. So we're actually going to do that. Every unit's going to attack Shrewsbury.
As you command, my liege.
And we can actually assault them now, which might be a good idea. We're going to maintain siege for the time being. No point staying in Montgomery. Absolute waste. Rodri and the 3 units can go into Montgomery. There we go. Happy population crisis averted. And then...
Yes, my lord.
These 2 units can stay there for now in case Chester rebels. Chester comes out and takes the fort, or attempts to take the fort. We'll have Prince David then that can counterattack there. So, pretty decent plan so far. Cardiff is going to be besieged soon. Gloucester won't know if they need a shit shave or a haircut because they have either got to sit there or try and relieve the pressure at Cardiff or try and take Shrewsbury back from me, because hopefully I will be taking Shrewsbury in this part. We're going to use the King, King Llewellyn, to attack Shrewsbury. We're going to use the ballistas. I could auto resolve this, but it's the first battle of this campaign and I want to actually fight it. So let's fight the battle on the battle map. King Llewellyn versus Captain Perkin. I could have gone for a knight attack, but I'm just going to go straight in. I actually want to see what I'm doing in this battle, so it would be a good idea to not have knight attack selected. So this is going to be interesting. Here we go. Let's listen to the speech.
The time for battle has come, but it is not my way to send men into needless peril or throw lives away. Be assured, I will not ask any more of you than I would ask of myself. I ask only that you fight with honor and do not turn your back to the foe. Together, then, we will have victory, for such is to my taste and my custom in battle. It grieves me, Grunin.
Okay, that's enough. pardon me. Get the ballistas into shape. We're aiming for the gates. They're right by there. Just get them there. Start the battle. Get them to aim. Get my spearmen. I've got to try to remember all the controls now. It does change slightly. I need to check my... oh god, where's it gone? UI option, I think. Minimal HUD, battle HUD. That's fine. Oh my god, where is it? Restrict camera, we don't want that, do we? And then... I'll look for it after. I need to change the keys, basically. I'm using the directional buttons rather than WASD. I'm used to WASD, so it's rather unfortunate, I must say. Oh, there we go. Ballista shots. Ballista be firing. And we be hitting the gate. And I'd, for some reason, I'm sounding Irish right now. Ballista be... Oh, my God. I can't do a good Irish accent. Ballista be firing, man. That was terrible. If you're Irish, I do apologise. But, you know, that's YouTube for you. So we've grouped up my archers. We're going to actually put them behind my spearmen. Gwent raiders can go on the flank like so. Cavalry can be grouped up with my general, so let's get them grouped up. They can be in a position on the right flank. My ballistas can be firing while this is going on. want to take Shrewsbury nice and cleanly. Do as much damage to that gate as we possibly can. A reinforced gate. It's working relatively well. Let's just fast forward this slightly. Get that gate down. 75% damage. 90%. One more volleys. Go back to normal speed. A little bit more, lads. A little bit more. Oh shit, they missed. You can do it, lads. Put some pressure on it. You gotta put some pressure on it. You gotta put a little bit of pressure on it. There we go.
Down.
Hell yeah. That worked very well. So what we're gonna do now, pardon me, we're gonna take my ballistas and they're actually gonna aim for that big massive cluster that the enemy has decided to leave there. These units here, my Welsh Merionoedd spearmen, are going to be key in this campaign. They're relatively cheap, they get 75 men per unit, and they're absolutely beastly. They're very good at holding and penning down units for Wales. If you can use the Merionoedd spearmen with, combined with Scythe Wheel, you can have a devastating defensive army. And Wales have one of the best defensive armies in the Britannia campaign, in my opinion. So that's what we're going to try and do. My bows can actually be brought up now. Oop, what's happened there? For some reason the bows aren't... Oh, there they go. Finally worked. Yeah, as you can tell, I'm a little bit rusty when it comes to Medieval 2. Like I said, I haven't played a Wales campaign for probably 5 or 6 years. And this is my first ever Medieval 2 YouTube campaign. I've been holding off a long time to play. But I felt like now would be a perfect time. And something to look forward to in the new year. I want to start the year off with a bang. And I think Medieval 2 is the way to go. Not long before Attila Total War is released, so I think it's a good time as any, really. I'm going to use the Gwent Raiders. They're going to be like my relief force on the skirmishers. They can jump in against the town militia and do a relatively good job there. And my ballista can actually continue to fire upon the mailed knights and the cavalry. Weaken them. We're going to be very aggressive here. We're going to actually charge my spearmen in now. Let's have a little look at this. We're just going to completely throw ourselves in and charge. Towers are going to be doing a little bit of damage on us as well, so we need to be rather wary
our
of them.
Soldiers have proved their worth today. The enemy's
village has been captured, which is excellent.
Now.
They don't know what they're going to do. There we go, lovely. All our units are engaging the town militia. Our bows can actually aim for the town militia that are running that way instead. Ballista will be doing a lot of damage. 60,
61. Our men are winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
They are frightened. They are shaken. Gwent Raiders can charge in now. Pardon me. Have a little look at the action, guys. And also, I'd be grateful for feedback in this campaign. Any sort of feedback is grateful, whether it be some of the strategies that I'm utilizing, whether it be the audio, whether it be some of the gameplay mechanics that I've got installed, like the UI or whatever. Any sort of feedback would be grateful and appreciated. Look at that. I haven't taken one loss yet with the spearmen. And the town militia are down to 6. Spearmen are brilliant for Wales in this campaign. I'm going to use lots of them in these in this campaign. I'm going to try and line them up now to a decent formation. We've routed them, done enough damage on them. The bows can come in as well. So the cavalry's been weakened and weakened. Mailed knights, archer militia, they're all going to be weakened. Gwent Raiders can get themselves in there as well, actually. And then the cavalry can actually get themselves into the building as well. Let's charge the archers. Ballista be doing a lot of damage, which is very, very nice indeed. We're actually going to put enable fire at will on, as well as flaming ballista. Gotta watch out we don't do damage to our own men. We're gonna aim for the back. Oh, look at that. That's even better. I'm just gonna completely destroy this place. I don't care. I just want to destroy the English. Kill them all. Bloodthirsty. Very, very bloodthirsty. Right, cavalry. Can we flank around? I think we might be able to. I don't know. Could try it, I suppose. Let's bring the cavalry
our
back
men
here.
Are winning the battle. If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Just gonna bring them back. So we can get a nice clean charge through the side. Bows.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Bows have very good range. They're able to fire from back there. Very good units for Wales. We're doing a very good job as well. And the cavalry just sitting there. This is one of the things with Medieval too. They do tend to sit back in their kind of holding point, capture point. So, you know, it is. I suppose in a way it is kind of easy to game the game, if that makes sense. I don't know. Get Llewellyn into a decent charge position. King Llewellyn the Great. Llewellyn ap Gruffydd. Give a rally call as well. We're actually going to get the spearmen involved now. Gwent Raiders and the spearmen against the cavalry if possible. Cavalry are weak to spearmen. Oh, look at that.
The enemy general lies dead.
Oh, what a shot.
We've sent the base cur to hell.
That was one hell of a shot, guys. Enemy general's dead. Killed by a ballista. And we're just completely destroying this place. Actually, I think, have we got good aim range with them? Yes, we have got good range with these, that's okay. Just wanted to check. Wasn't 100% sure. Right, we're going to push through now. I think the ballista can probably stop firing, so we'll disable the rest. I'm going to turn them that way instead. Don't need them firing. Just going to charge through to the cavalry, the mailed knights. Gwent Raiders, they can get on the town militia. All the spearmen can get involved on the cavalry. And even Llewellyn himself is going to get a charge in. And my other cavalry. I'm going to fast forward this. We're going to be very decisive in this battle. We haven't lost barely anything. It's been absolutely great start to this campaign, I think.
My lord, we've lost control of the city.
Just charge in now. Everyone just get in there. Run. Just going to completely decimate the light infantry. Fast forward again. Throw ourselves in. There we go. Lovely jubbly. Doing a very good job indeed. There he is. The King of Wales in all his glory. Llewellyn ap Gruffydd. Do they have any left? I can't see anyone. I think we've done it. Are there any English left? I'm actually going to tell my archer to turn around. They might hit my old men from there. I don't know if there are any English left. Can't see them. Have they glitched out? I don't know. I have no idea what's going on, guys. We're going to fast forward anyway. We are capturing the capture point. All my men are lined up. I don't know what's going on. I think there might be a unit stuck there somewhere, but we've pretty much massacred the English in this part anyway. Here we go, we've captured the point. End of the battle there.
This is a clear
fantastic
victory that goes to only men of great virtue and valour.
Look at that. 627, lost 71. They've only got two remaining. We're gonna continue we're gonna click the tick and continue with the campaign. And Shrewsbury is ours in the first part of this campaign. Fantastic.
Glory, honour! Victory!
King Llewellyn, the absolute
Lord,
beast. We're going to occupy.
Our courage and honor have
I think
conquered.
We're going to occupy. Yes, we're going to occupy this settlement. And he is winning first, so he's got plus one dread. And enemy army routes. Done a fantastic job there, King Llewellyn.
Where
and my
to,
spy
sir?
Can now. See, Rhys is near Gloucester. So we need to just check our borders for now. So we've taken Shrewsbury in the first part. Llewellyn's going to move from Shrewsbury. Shrewsbury. He's going to go for Gloucester. It'll take about two turns in the West Country, so that'll be great. Chester is going to be our next kind of port of call. So I want to recruit some decent units in Montgomeryshire. So let's have a look. We've got some more ballista, which would be great. Like I said, the spearmen, Merinoid spearmen are good, useful units to have. Hellweir longbowmen. and a catapult. I think they'd be great units to have recruited here in Montgomery. And then Carnarvon itself. Lots and lots of cavalry. This is where you want to recruit all your cavalry from. Scythewaves, bowmen again, one of them. And then a unit of mailed knights. I think that would be good enough there. So there we go. That is the first part of this Great Wales campaign. I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.